Yeah, that was a nice tune, I would say. Today I've been traveling around and I planned to take a long journey away. Visit Uri Geller's museum because I saw an interview with him earlier this year, and it would be intriguing to maybe meet Uri Geller. But he comes from a country that is all about miracles, all about strange happenings. I think what God promised Abraham is out of this world. It's very strange because if you follow me, I will be with you. And that walk with me, walk in faith. And Abraham never doubted God's calling. I talked with a guy today at the end of the road in the basement of a shopping mall. Yeah, sitting down because I've been standing in queue for minutes, not very long, but it needs patience. So I say to fellow queuers, I realize that here I need to exercise my patience. So they totally agree with that, laughing, and we try to enjoy ourselves while waiting. And today I was a little bit tampered, so to say. I went to the main board of a cashier where they have a platform in the shopping mall, in the shopping center, and I said we need more people to be cashiers because here, look at all the crowd that have been gathering. I met a guy when I came to the grocery center. Big grocery center. I just don't see the end of it. And I remember the place during the time I was volunteering here. I was in this guest house, and we went to this big shopping grocery center in order to buy the food we need. And it's where you buy loads of stuff. You don't see the end of it. And all the courages that the people have taken for 5 shekel, and they get the return of this 5 shekel every time they deliver the wagon again. I see that all their wagons are completely full, and I don't know how they could pay for that. My shopping bag is just a tiny little end. I buy chips and this malt soda with malt. And it's quite nice. There you can get so much for free. And I met this guy that had this kippa on the side, on the side, always on the side. And an energetic, strong, filled boy. And with long hair like Orthodox. And He didn't mind me much, but he was in a good mood. So I'm happy. I'm happy that he was in a good mood. Because this guy, you don't play with such a guy. And he may have been 18, 17, 18 years old. And really energetic. And when I complained to the cashier that they should have more cashiers, this guy came, and I said, "You can put now. You can put this guy on. He is the professional. He is super. He do it so fast." And he said, "No, no, no. I can't do it now." And I said, "Next hour, okay. Next hour, we will have to wait to next hour." And I try to make people laugh, and I sat down at the end of the road after shopping this at this grocery. I sat at a bench where I'm Arab. Almost was sleeping while talking in the phone, and I see that he straightened up when I came, and a father with his child came, and we get to talk with each other, and he had several children, and I said to him, being in Israel, "Aren't you afraid?" "No, really, I don't feel afraid like that. I feel good by being here. I think I need to be here," and so on. And I said, "What I recognize here is that you have families, and you just love each other." As I told yesterday, this two elderly gentlemen that was hugging and kissing this little child on his mother's arm, holding the child, and they couldn't get enough of this hugging and kissing, and they forgot the bus. Now they are stuck at the bus station more than 1 hour. So it was that was funny, and I continued. Where is that? Here I can see this. I went along, I took the bus 34 to the shopping mall, and I came back again, and when I reached home, this is it's mirrored. I don't know how to undo the mirroring. But this is Stand With Us. Stand With Us. This is an organization that have tours, informations, and much more that they are doing here in Israel. And I said to them, it's good for me. I try to make people smile here, but this is in fact more important for me than I think it will ever be for Israel, because I need to be here. I was stopped by the war and the family that said, "No, no, no, don't go now," and I totally respect, and I think it was a wise decision. But this time, I got their blessing, and now I'm here, and experience each and every day something very unique and very nice. And a lady with her guitar together with a friend, lady friend, and yes, stopped. "Are you playing this guitar?" "Yes." Said, "Continue playing." So this is kind of a Uri Geller state. People, despite the threat of war, are continuing their life. That's the spirit of Israel. I wish I could have such a spirit that it never ends. So with that, shalom.